Do you ever need to present a chart or a graph in a meeting? The way you set up that slide matters. Let's do a test. You're the manager, I'm presenting to you. I'm going to do two different slides, same story. Ready? Here's presentation number one. Let's have a look at our sales volume for this year so far. The countries with the highest sales are USA, Germany, and India. Although USA is the highest in absolute terms, there is a big negative deviation to budget due to an unplanned shutdown. Germany is also behind budget, but India is ahead of budget by more than 20% due to a successful product launch. You got that? Here's number two. Let's have a look at our sales volume for this year so far. The countries with the highest sales are USA, Germany, and India. Although USA is the highest in absolute terms, there is a big negative deviation to budget due to an unplanned shutdown. Germany is also behind budget, but India is ahead of budget by more than 20% due to a successful product launch. Notice the difference? I know a lot of people are against animations in business presentations. They can be seen as unprofessional or distracting, but not when they are there to emphasize the points in your story. You see, when you put up a visualization that has a lot of information, your audience's attention goes from you to the slide. They stop listening to you and they start figuring out on their own what's on that slide. When your chart animation supports your story, you keep them with you, fully engaged. Let me show you how to animate your Excel charts in PowerPoint. Our starting point is Excel. We're first going to create the charts in Excel, then we're going to animate with PowerPoint. Let's first insert the chart for the actual data, highlight country and actual column, go to insert, and insert a clustered column chart. Select the series, right mouse click, and add data labels to this. Now we can remove the y-axis. Let's also remove the grid lines and the title. We're going to have our own title in the PowerPoint presentation. I'm also going to reduce the gap width just to make the bars thicker and bring them closer together. Let's also change the bar color to a gray color, which is my favorite color. Now, as the next step, we need to add a second series to this to dynamically highlight the three largest sales values. We're going to do this through a separate series because that's basically the main trick in Excel. Whenever you work with charts and you want to conditionally format the data in the chart, you need to add a new series. That new series is also going to enable us to do our animation in PowerPoint. So all we need to do for this is to come up with a formula that enables us to get the three largest numbers out of this data set. Let's start off with the if function. We're going to check if cell B4 is greater or equal to the third largest number in this data set. So here we can use the large function. Highlight our data set here. Don't forget to press F4 to fix the referencing because we don't want that to shift when we pull our formula down. We want to get the third largest number out. And if the value is true, so if that value is greater than or equal to the third largest number, then we want to see that number. Otherwise, we want to see nothing or zero and send this down. We get our three top numbers. Now, all we have to do is add this new series to our chart. Right mouse click, select data, add series. Series name is the title here, and the series values are our values that we just calculated. Now, first thing I'm going to do, since I'm already in the fill options, let's just change the fill color to a nice green. And now, of course, we want this to overlap, so we need to adjust the series overlap and change this to 100%. That's our conditional formatting. Now, as a last step, let's just remove the border around this chart. Shape outline, no outline. Our first chart is completed. Let's add our second chart where we want to calculate the variance from actual to budget. That's a simple formula, actual minus budget, and send the formula down. Now let's insert a column chart for this as well. So highlight the country column, hold down Control key, and highlight the change column. Go to insert and insert a column chart. Now this doesn't look nice, so let's just do some formatting to this. I'm going to take away the shape fill so that I can easily check if the columns for the change are below the original series. Let's remove the axes and add data labels to this. Now, the other thing I don't need are the horizontal axis labels. So I'm going to remove them by going to axis options under labels, label position, change this to none. This keeps the line, hides the labels. Now the other thing I'm going to do to make this look neater is to increase the gap width to the max. This is going to give me much thinner bars. And then all I have to do is position them underneath my actual chart. Now, it would also be nice to have the negative bars formatted in a different color to the positive bars and have this in a dynamic way. There is a great feature for this. It's in the fill options, invert if negative. The moment you activate this and you select your first color, you get the option to select the second color. So the first color is for the positive series and the second color is the color you want to have for your negative series. Now, if I was keeping this in Excel, I would group these two different charts together so I can move them as one object. But since we're taking them to PowerPoint, we can't group them because moving a grouped chart object to PowerPoint is going to change it to an image. So activate the first chart and press Ctrl C or right mouse click copy. Let's go to PowerPoint. So I've prepared an empty slide here with the header that I want and then right mouse click and paste it as a link. And I've kept the source formatting in this case. Do the same thing for the second chart and keep the source formatting. Now I'm just going to expand them and make them bigger here. You're free on the PowerPoint side to change the color of your chart, to add or remove elements from here. They're not going to impact your Excel chart. What is connected between the two is the data set. So the moment the numbers change on the Excel side, they're going to pull through on the PowerPoint side. So let's just make some cosmetic changes to this so that the numbers and the labels are easy to see, even if there are people sitting further away in the audience. Now our chart is done. Let's just take a look at it. It's without animation. If you just show this, there is a lot of information to take in. So it would be better to paste the information. Let's start off with the actual chart. Go to the Animations tab. We can pick an animation from here. Now, I usually either go with Appear, Fade, or if I'm working with charts, I like to use Wipe. That's going to give me this type of effect, which I like. The default effect option for charts is to bring it in as one object, but we don't want it as one object, we want it by series. So remember, we have two different series here, the original one for actual, series number two is the top three sales numbers. Okay, so that's the animation for chart one done. It's really easy. For chart two, I'm going to do it slightly different. I'm going to animate it by category. I just have one series in there, but I don't want to bring all the information in one go. I want to paste the information based on my story. So let's just check this out. First comes actual, then comes the top three numbers. Then comes each category one after another. So every time I'm pressing the mouse click, the next category is coming on. Now, if you have a lot of data, this might be too much clicking. So let's just change this a bit and make it match our story. So I concentrate first on USA, and that has the biggest negative impact. So I want to give that a separate type of animation. I'm going to use wipe, but because my data is going the other way around, I want the effect to go from top to bottom instead of bottom to up, which is the default for wipe. Now, for the other four categories, there isn't much to explain about those, so I want them to appear at the same time. And I can do that by clicking the number 7, 8, and 9, because those are the ones I want to appear the moment number 6 appears. So I'm going to highlight them, right mouse click, and start with previous. The India category, that's the one that I want to talk about separately, so I'm going to apply wipe to this and just keep the default effect option. So now let's check this out. That's our actual numbers first, bringing attention to top three numbers, talking about USA, mentioning Germany while we show all the four countries, and then talking about India. Okay, so that's it. Now as a last test, let's just make sure that this is dynamic. Let's go and change the number for India to 9,200. So that reduces our change to 200. Let's switch to PowerPoint. It's already updated. And notice that our actual numbers, the top three countries, have changed to USA, Canada, and Germany. Now, in case your link doesn't refresh automatically, you can go to the Chart Design tab and click on Refresh Data. I encourage you to test different chart animations. Just make sure they're not distracting. Instead, they should help emphasize your story. As Simon Sinek says, start with the end goal in mind. In his course, Presentation Essentials, available on Skillshare, he takes us through the storytelling aspect of the presentation and gives us tips on designing the talk. Now, because this class is on Skillshare, which is an online learning community, once you register, you get access to more than 25,000 classes in business, finance, and marketing. Their premium membership gives you unlimited access so you can join the classes that are right for you and your career goals. So whether you want to fuel your curiosity, creativity, or career, Skillshare is the perfect place to keep you learning and thriving. They have a subscription plan which is super affordable. An annual subscription is less than $10 a month. And here's the best part. The link in the description of this video gives you 2 months free trial with unlimited access. Click that link and join more than 7 million students learning with Skillshare. Thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring this video and supporting my channel. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you want to get updates when new videos come out.